Can you make money with these? Yes, you can. And in my opinion, it's an unreasonable amount of money. Look at them. They suck. Contrary to popular belief, you don't really need a lot of tools, and you don't actually need any experience. Now, some people take advantage of this, but in my opinion, not enough do.
In all seriousness, this is a fantastic side hustle that can make you between...
I made that video last summer. It's currently the winter of next year, and I was literally too busy fixing and selling lawnmowers to finish it. Okay, so here's a little backstory on me with lawnmowers. Oh, third. Caught third right there. I'm on some slippery roads right now in the old Chevy. Okay, anyway. When I was 15, I had gotten into small engine repair already by dirt bikes and go-karts and things that I rode when I was younger. So I learned how to fix those a little bit. And then I met a good friend of mine who actually bought, fixed, and sold lawnmowers. At the time, I just had a pickup truck, didn't even have a trailer yet. And I wrote up a little ad on Facebook that said I pick up riding lawnmowers, and messages just flooded in. So I would just go pick up lawnmowers, fix whatever was wrong with them, hit them with a buffer real quick so they looked relatively new, write up a nice ad, and sell them for a couple $100, profit a piece. As I was just in high school, I wasn't even working at a normal job, and I was making good money with just flipping lawnmowers on the side. Anyone can do it, regardless of what you got. So.
Do you have $100?
Do you have $100 in your piggy bank? Do you have $100 under your bed? Does your mom have $100? I just kidding, don't steal from your mom. You might have $100 in your G-string, like me. Chances are, you do have $100 somewhere. I'm going inside, because it's cold.
The moral of my story is that if you have $100, you have a lot more than $100 at the same time. All it takes is a little bit of investments. The buy low, sell high strategy can work with absolutely anything. And in this case, I'm gonna show you how it works with lawnmowers. You don't need to be smart, you don't need to have a lot of capital, and you don't need to have that many materials to make some money. So, it's the end of January, it's 30 degrees out in Maryland, no one's mowing their lawns. But still, I'm gonna show you how $100, a pickup truck, and a Facebook account can turn this $100 into a lot more money just using lawnmowers. So,
sorry.
Let's get started.
All it takes is an old picture of a lawnmower, a random price, an all caps title, and a well-written description saying that you pay cash for lawnmowers. Post it in as many groups as you can and wait for the hits to come. Let's get it! I'm excited. $40 for our first lawnmower. It has only been one day since I put that ad out. I've got, I'd say, three or four people that already have mowers for me to pick up, but this one is the cheapest by far. This is a Poulon, which is the same as a Craftsman, very common, reliable, easy to sell. And the person said they got a new mower and don't need this one anymore. It's been sitting for about a year, which means it basically needs some light TLC, nothing too crazy, and it'll be back on track. So I'm excited to pick it up, going about 15 minutes away. Excited to take it home, assess it, see what it needs, see how cheap we can fix it, and move on with this. All right, picked it up. It is incredibly cold out today. That's why I'm wearing this super cool mask. Anyways, got the lawnmower. It's in pretty good shape, gonna need a lot of cleaning. It's covered in about a foot of dirt, but I'm excited to see if we can get it to fire up, clean it up, sell it.
Forgive me here because my audio stopped working, but all I had to do was drop the old battery out, put a $20 battery in from Walmart, and the thing started right up. As you can see here by the smoke, it's running. Put it in reverse, the thing even moves as it should. And to top it all off, the mower works as it should as well. So We're ready to go. All it needs to do is get clean. Now, make sure the lawnmower still runs and drives as it should. Take some good pictures, list it up with a good ad, and you'll be on your way.
Ready to be delivered. $560 because I'm going pretty far away. That's not bad profit for only having $60 into it, I don't think. All right, so it was listed for sale for, I have it up for $480. I'm delivering it about an hour away. Worked with him on the price a little bit, so I'm gonna bring it to him for $560, which is good because that's $500 of pure profit because all I did was put a battery in and wash it, so. All right, so I just dropped off that mower and he actually gave me this one as a partial trade-in. So I knocked $60 off and took that one too. So. Still a pretty good profit, and I also got another mower.
All right, so we just dropped off that red mower, $500. I actually ended up taking his old lawnmower, which has a couple of small issues, as a trade-in, kind of like a car. So $440 profit for that red mower. All I had to do was put a battery in it and wash it, and the one that he traded in, that one still runs, drives, and cuts. It just needs a couple minor fixes. So I got that one. I value it at about $400 to $500, and that's just gonna be pure profit because everything that's wrong with it, I can fix with simple hand tools. So, $440 on our first mower, along with a trade-in valued at over $400. So, we're starting off this right.
All right, so we just got the lawnmower in, just fixed the small issues it had, so then now we're gonna wash it and list it back up for sale. The two things wrong with it were the steering wheel was broken, it was down in the shaft, so all I had to do was take the steering wheel off with one bolt. I ran a screw through it so the gear would stay in place. Very simple, just took a drill, popped a hole in it, put a screw in there, screwed it back down. Now the steering is nice and working as it should, and the hood was broken right here. So I just drilled holes in this plastic and ran some zip ties through there. It's to the point where you won't notice, and it doesn't really matter in pictures. Like, once it's all cleaned up, you won't notice. It's not a perfect looking mower, but I could still get $450 to $500 for it. And it was technically more than free. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna wash it up and then list it up. All right, well, the lawnmower is just listed and sold for $560. That's a pretty darn good deal for a mower that I got as a trade-in for technically basically free, or more than free. But let's keep on moving, see what we can buy next.
Well, with this newfound 500 some dollars, I'm gonna go pick up a zero turn. I found it listed up on Facebook for $500 even, and it's an excellent deal. And now that the spring season is coming up, lawnmowers are becoming a hot ticket. So this zero turn, which I'm heading to right now, is gonna be $500. And as you know, based off the other two lawnmowers, we definitely have that money to spend now. So we're gonna try and double it or more. All right, so we're leaving the guy's house right as we speak. This zero turn is a little rougher than I was hoping, but we got it for $350. That's why negotiation is key. So it obviously needs a battery and a little bit more cleaning up, but batteries are $20 and they take 2 minutes to swap. I only paid $350 for it, guaranteed can sell over $700 or better. So yeah, let's see what we can do.
All right, here it is, got a home. As you can see, it's pretty ugly and the seat foam is in the back of my truck, but it does run, drive, and cut as it should. All the tires seem pretty decent and it's got a V-twin on it. So it's a 48-inch deck zero turn. It's not the biggest, but these zero turns are easy sells and they get swiped up really quick. So I'm gonna clean it up, toss a battery in it, and we'll be on our way.
All right, well, it is literally 10 o'clock at night on a Friday. I listed that thing for sale 5 hours ago.
about 5 p.m. today. Took pictures of it, listed it for sale for $900. And somebody wanted it so bad, they loaded up their trailer and came here at 10:30 p.m. So that just proves that zero turns sell insanely easily. And also, I probably underpriced it a little. Only had 370 into it if we include the battery, which only costs $20 at Walmart. 370 bucks turned into 900 bucks. I'd say that's not too bad.
All right, well, I'm gonna cut it off there. We started with 60 bucks. We bought the first mower, a Coulon for 40. We put a $20 battery into it. That's where we got the $60. And then we sold it for $500. And we got a trade-in that didn't need any money. It just needed a little bit of maintenance, a little bit of tinkering. We sold that one for $560. So we immediately turned 60 into 1060. And then we took 370 out of that 1060. We bought the zero turn for 350, and then we bought a $20 battery for that zero turn. Listed that for sale, and within 5 hours, we sold that for 900. So when you do the math, it all comes out to $1,590, which if you want to subtract the 90 bucks, I would say for gas to pick them up, $1,500. So we turned $60 into $1,500 with very, very minimal effort. None of the mowers need serious repairs. It was just batteries, pressure wash, a little elbow grease. So I really believe that most people can do this. If you don't have a pickup truck, ask a friend. I'm sure they'd be happy to help you, lend you the truck, or do it with you. You can have some sort of a little partnership. Obviously, I'm very lucky to have a garage to work out of, and I, of course, have bought myself a trailer from doing this, and the trailer is very useful as well, but this can be done just as easily with only a truck of any size, really. I also have some quick tips for mowers. One, try to spend between $20 and $150 for a decent mower. Two, try to buy mowers that ran last season. Like, they just parked them and they haven't tried to start them. They've just been sitting, they bought a new mower, blah, 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 blah. Those are the best ones to buy. Three, most mowers just need a battery and some fresh gas to fire up. At the worst, if you get one that ran last season, it might need a carburetor, which you can YouTube and Google how to fix. Very simple, very quick. But as you saw in this video, none of the mowers I bought required that. They just needed batteries and maybe a little bit of gas. Three. Four. If you do not have a pressure washer, like I have a pressure washer at my house, as you saw, go to a car wash, a self-serve car wash, where they have pressure washers for your cars. Just take the mower there on your truck, pressure wash it off, take it home. That step is taken care of. It costs you maybe $5. So yeah. Hopefully this video was somewhat helpful for you. Hopefully you can use this to your advantage. Maybe make a little bit of side money, get your hands dirty, and figure out if this is a decent side hustle for you. I know it's a great side hustle for me. I enjoy it. I like to fix things. I like to deal with people. So it's great for me. Hopefully it's great for you too. I hope you enjoyed the video. Be sure to like and subscribe if you really want to. And have a blessed day.